Well, Irene, there are lots of bunnies in that picture, but this is not the Lincoln Park Zoo.
It most certainly is not. Hi, welcome to tonight's PM Magazine. I'm Irene Rodriguez.
I'm Mike Leiderman. We are, of course, at the Playboy Club on Lincoln Park West, and hello.
Hi, welcome to Chicago Playboy Club.
Told you we're at the Chicago Playboy Club, huh?
Can you imagine what competition must be like to become a Playboy bunny?
Almost as tough as it is to be a TV star. And tonight we're going to show you how to become a Chicago TV star by being in commercials.
Then we'll see a Playboy bunny who joined the Marines.
And we're off to Chicago Hotspots with Aaron Gold. We'll visit a fine restaurant.
Then we'll take you behind the scenes of the hit show, Love Boat.
Do you want to be on TV? Well, lots of folks do. And they watch and say, if she's on or if he's on, well, heck, I can do it too. Let me tell you, it is a lot harder than it looks, but you can be in television, on TV commercials. And tonight, we're going to meet a Chicago woman who left her job and then decided to go into television. Would you believe she's made it? And you can too, maybe. Let's watch. Meet Yvette Edelhart. While her name may be unusual, she has a familiar face, the kind you'd be likely to see just about anywhere. Now there's that face again, only this time Yvette Edelhart is on a television commercial.
WFYR 103.5 FM.
I've been in hospitals and had somebody come up and say, say, I've seen you somewhere before. And no, you've never seen them. And you say, do you watch TV? Yes. I said, do you remember the little old lady in the WFYR commercial? Yes. I say, I'm the little old lady. And then they go, oh, yeah, yeah, that's you, that's you. I recognize you right away.
Yvette has been doing commercial work only about a year. She worked behind a desk for years before that and started dabbling in community theater just recently. But once she got a taste of show business, Yvette quickly realized she wasn't long for the office. So she quit to try her hobby as a new career.
I just had to do it. Now, I know that sounds foolish, but I felt that at this time in my life, with this newfound talent that I found that I had, I needed to go out and try it.
Okay, Yvette. Yvette Edelhart. All right.
One of Yvette's first stops was the Chicago TV Actors Studio downtown, where Paul Cook teaches a course for would-be commercial stars. For a few $100s, people from any walk of life can learn how to audition for television commercials, and they don't have to look like Brooke Shields or Tom Selleck to make it.
My name's Yvette Edelhart.
No longer do you have to be a glamorous movie star type. They're looking for real people, people with the average look. And that's important to clients and manufacturers and people who are spending money on advertising. They want to relate to the average buyer.
Yvette quickly found out what few people suspect when they watch TV. The job is a lot harder than it looks. Even saying your own name can be a challenge at first.
Hello. My name is Yvette Edelhart.
Okay, do it once more without the swallow.
Hello, my name is Yvette Edelhart.
There's a certain technique to it, like anything else. And it taught me how to hold a script, how to read a script, how to stand up and present myself, how to mark a script so that you can read it intelligently and say what it is that, that the client wants you to say.
You must audition effectively. Usually the audition is tougher than the job itself. You're under a lot of pressure. There are clients generally there. The videotape is running for the audition most of the time. And so you must have confidence in an audition and do a believable job.
Don't rent or buy until you've heard about the greatest new home values ever.
Paul Cook himself is an established commercial pitchman, actor, and model. For the past 5 years, he's used his acting school to train several hundred others to be commercial performers.
We get them used to the camera, used to performing effectively, we hope, and believably, and sincerely, and reading scripts with intelligence.
For every 3 sessions, you get one free. No more greasy oils or sticky lotions.
Where'd you get the recipe?
From the Tribune.
The food section of the Tribune.
Why not call your local National Trust agent today? They're in the yellow pages.
They're good.
Sitting there and you've got script right up in front of your face and you're moving all over the place and your hands and your body and your head are going 4 different directions and it's terrible. And you realize where you've got to go from there.
This week only,
at the donut hole nearest you.
Yvette worked hard and had a little luck, too. One of her first auditions after the course led to a job, a big one, a commercial for Illinois Bell Telephone.
I asked him for a raise.
Really?
There was a room full of professional people there when I auditioned, and I really didn't think they would pick me. I mean, we had a great time at the audition, and they laughed, and it was a lot of fun. I was just thrilled.
You've had a chance to look at that storyboard out there.
Since her first commercial, Yvette has become a real pro at auditions. Even so, they're never routine. This one is being done by a Chicago ad agency, Watchering and Kowalski. It's for the Illinois State Lottery.
Run through it real quickly one more time, okay? What you're doing is you've just won a whole pot of money, okay, in the lottery game, and you don't know what you're going to do with it. She was one of those late bloomers, which is kind of neat because she's a great lady and she started off in a career like midstream in life. But she's also a perfect age because there's a lot of people out there who buy products at that age, which makes her a saleable commodity. Yvette, what I want you to do is be a little kind of like shocked in amazement that you got this money.
Okay.
And then we'll go into the money drops.
There are 24 other actors up for the same part, so the competition is fierce. In fact, any TV commercial actor, no matter how good, had better learn quickly that rejection is part of the job.
You always would like to get the job. You'd like to sign the contract. You'd like to, you know, complete the sale, sell the house, sell the insurance policy. But if you don't, you go on and you knock at the next door.
Freeze frame and cut. Great. Wonderful. Thank you very much. That's all we needed to do.
If you go out of there saying, oh, if I had just done this, oh, if I had worn that, oh, if I had done this,
thank you for coming.
You're in the wrong business. You have to go in, present yourself, do the best you can, thank them, leave, and then forget about it.
In the end, Yvette did not get the lottery job, but that didn't faze her. She continues her routine, more auditions, more callbacks, and she hopes more parts.
We have a whole club of middle-aged, chunky ladies who go out, and I suppose in a way there's competition, but in a way we know one another and we're friends.
And if you'd still like to be a TV commercial star, take the advice of the pros. Be prepared to work hard and know what you're in for, but by all means, give it a try, and good luck. Stay tuned. Next, we're going to a Chicago hotspot on PM Magazine.
Dirtiest group in camp. Bet Angie borrows my detergent again.
And my family.